Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about normal labor. Normal labor, a series of events that take place in female genital organs to expel the product of conception, the fetus placenta membranes, out of the womb through the vagina into the outer world. In simple language, I can say the process of delivery. After the 9 months, after the 48 weeks, the baby, the fetus, how it is coming out through the vagina to the external world. So the process is called labor. The various stages will take place in the labors. There are 4 stages we will discuss later. Before that, let's discuss about the physiology of labor and what are all the points we need to remember during the labor. The normal labor, it should be spontaneous and at term. That means the delivery has to happen at the 48th week after the 9 months. If it is occurring before the term, it is called preterm. If it is beyond the term, that is called as post-term. So when it is considered as normal labor, that is only at the term, it should be with vertex presentation. So this is the vertex presentation. The head should be down. It should be in a complete flexion attitude, lie should be longitudinal. So this is vertex. In later classes, we'll see what is vertex presentation and all. So it should be with vertex presentation without undue prolongation. So it should not be prolonged. Like suppose if it is taking 4, 5, 6 hours, beyond that, the second stage, it should be completed in 2 hours. In priming. So if it is taking more than 3, 4, 5 hours, so that might be obstructed labor or prolonged labor, so which will not considered as normal labor. And natural termination without minimal aid, that will be termed as normal labor. Without having any complications affecting the health of the mother and the baby. If there are any complications, we should not go for the normal labor. We have to send the woman mother to the cesarean section. If the mother is suffering with cephalopelvic disproportion or the baby is large babies. So in cases of hypertension, pregnancy induced hypertension, in those cases, the woman has to go for cesarean section. So these are the points should be remembered. Let's see causes of onset of labor. How the causes will initiate the labor. What are all the causes? First one is the uterine distension and fetoplacental contribution. Here activation of fetal hypothalamic pituitary axis will occur, which will increase the CRT, corticotropin releasing hormone. Then it will initiate increase of ACTH, that is adrenocorticotropic hormone, which will going to accelerate production of estrogen and also prostaglandin from the placenta. So these are the causes of onset of labor. And what happened when the estrogen and progesterone levels are increasing here? So when estrogen will initiate the release of oxytocin from maternal pituitary, and it will promote the synthesis of myometrial receptors and stimulate synthesis of myometrial contraction protein. It increases the excitability of myometrial cells, though it encourages the fetus to come out through entire contractions. So progesterone, this also play an important role. See, this alteration of estrogen and progesterone ratio, it should be associated with the prostaglandin synthesis. And prostaglandin, major site of production is amnion and chorion. These are the membranes of the fetus and decidual cells and myometry. So, oxytocin. Oxytocin, this plays a very important role during the labor. It stimulates the uterine contractions and stimulates the prostaglandin production from amnion and decidua, so that the delivery process will be easy due to this uterine contraction. Suppose if the woman, if she is not getting uterine contractions or pains, so oxytocin should be administered during the labor. So let's see, before the labor, there are where we can feel, where we have to find out, is it true labor pains or false labor pains? So how we have to recognize this true labor pains, false labor pains? So most of the women, what happened at the 9 months, if they have some indigestion or if they cannot hold their pregnancy for so long, they are feeling slight abdominal pain, they may mistake it, they will mistaken that they are getting a true labor pain. So how to identify that true and false labor if they have indigestion or constipation? So how to differentiate that, we'll see. True labor, how to identify this true labor pain? So here, uterine contractions at regular intervals, where in the false labor, where we can find only dull pain confined to groin and abdomen. And in the true labor, contractions will be frequent, intensity, duration increases gradually. What happened here, pain interval does not shorten. Like they get the pain, it will not in an increasing way. And associated with the show, we can see the mucus plug outside the vagina. And here in the false labor, pain intensity remains the same. The intensity will not increase here in false labor, and progressive effacement and dilatation of cervix, where the baby is coming, like descent part will occur. Continuation, the baby is coming down to the pelvic floor, and dilatation of cervix we can see. Here no cervical dilatation in the false labor, and descent of presenting part, descent continuously, the baby is coming down to the pelvic floor. So that is the descent of presenting part. And here we can see no hardening of the uterus and formation of bags of water. So here we can feel the through the vagina there is a bag of water. All the water, amniotic fluid will be, all the membranes will be coming down. We can feel that bags of water. So the pain in the true labor pains are true labor. When we give enema or sedatives, it will not be subsided. It will not be relieved by enema. But here, when we give enema and sedatives, the pain will be relieved. That means it is considered as false labor. So this is the difference between true labor and false labor. Let's see physiology of normal labor. So there will be a marked hypertrophy and hyperplasia of uterine muscles and length of the uterus plus cervix, that is about 35 centimeter. So the in normal uterus size is 7.5 centimeter. When it grows to the 35 centimeter, 30 to 35 centimeter at term, and uterus assumes piriform ovoid shape, we can see, and cervical canal occluded by thick tenacious mucus plugs, as I said before. Let's see the stages of labor here. So there are 4 stages. First stage, second stage, third stage, fourth stage. Let's see what is this first stage. First stage concerned with the formation of birth canal. It is also called as, here I didn't mention, it is also first stage also called as cervical stage. So the main events which takes place here, dilatation of cervix and effacement of cervix and lower uterine segment formation. The baby which is going to come down, descent will take place. So this stage will start with the through labor pains and end with the full dilatation of cervix. This stage will start with the true labor pains and ends with the full dilatation of cervix. How many hours? This first stage will be there for primary 12 hours. And for the multi gravida, 6 hours will continue. Next, second stage of labor. So this begins with the cervical dilatation, where first stage ends with the cervical dilatation. Here it will start with the cervical dilatation and complete and ends with the fetal delivery. Fetus will come out. It will take place in the primary, approximately 2 hours in the primary gravida and half an hour, that is 30 minutes in the multigravida. Uterine contraction and accompanying expulsive forces like 16 to 90 seconds. So there are two stages in the, two events takes place in the second stage of labor. That is propulsive phase, expulsive phase. Propulsive phase, period of full dilatation until the head will touch the pelvic floor. So imagine this is a baby, then the baby is touching the pelvic floor. That is propulsive. So, and expulsive phase is the baby will expelled out from the uterus. That is expulsive phase. Let's see the diagram here. So I think it's not clear. You can see here. Here the baby is touching the pelvic floor and delivery of the baby takes place. The baby will come out. That is expulsive stage. So here in first stage, full true labor pains and full dilatation of cervix. In the second stage, propulsive, expulsive. Propulsive means the head is touching the pelvic floor and the baby will come out. That is expulsive stage. So that is the second stage. What is this third stage? What happens in the third stage? Include separation and descent and expulsion of placenta. So now the baby has came out. The remaining part will be placenta. So placenta will be removed manually after the delivery of the baby or fetus. There are two types of placental separation. That is, what is first one is a central, that is called as Schultz, and the second one is the marginal, Matthew Duncan method. So this here you can see this when it is in a central point. So that central Schultz method will be used, and if it is at a margin side by side, so marginal or Matthew Duncan method will be followed. So this stage will take place approximately 15 minutes in primary, also 15 minutes in multigravida. So it depends upon the gynecologist how she can do actively, how she can remove that placenta actively. So that is about third stage. Let's see the fourth stage. Fourth stage is nothing but observational stage. So when after the placenta membranes and umbilical cord should be examined for the completeness, check for any laceration of birth canal. So in the lacerations, episiotomy also done. If not, if there are any lacerations has been occurred, check for that. There are types of degrees of laceration, first degree, second degree and third degree. So we'll discuss this in detail in next class, what are all these lacerations and all. Next, how we are going to manage, do the management for this labor, for the first stage of labor. In first stage, rest and ambulation, because they are suffering with the labor pains, and oral intake, urinary bladder function, bladder will be distended, avoided, because it can hinder descent of the fetal presenting part, and pain relief methods should be followed. According to the physician, we need to administer the drug and monitor fetal well-being during the labor, and uterine contractions. Evaluate the uterine, how much is the frequency, duration, and intensity of the uterine contraction, and prepare for the second stage. So that is next second stage. What you have to do in the second stage? I said that second stage management of second stage of labor, preparation for the delivery. Put the patient in a dorsal lithotomy position, are lying flat on the bed. Clean the vulva, perineum with antiseptic solution. Clean hands, clean surface, clean cutting and ligature of the cord. Catheterization of bladder if it is full. So these are the things we should do in the second stage of labor. Then conduction of the delivery. Here maintain flexion of the head, prevent the early extension and regulate the escape out of vulval outlet. So this we have to do in the second stage. Third stage, placental separation, as I said previously, that should be done in two methods. So change the position into the dorsal position, hand placed over the fundus. Signs of separation, we can see state of uterine activity, detect any inversion of the uterus. Expulsion of the placenta, patient asked to bear down and placenta grasped by the hands and twisting round and round with the gentle traction, and it should be removed safely. And check that if there are any parts remaining inside the uterus. Examination of placenta after removing placenta. See the this is called the maternal fetal surface where the umbilical cord is joined. Maternal surface is what? Where the it is attached to the fundus of the mother. See for any incompleteness or completeness, anomalies, membranes are complete or not, completely removed or not, because if any particles are remain inside, it may cause infection to the uterus. Cord, number of vessels, you need to check the arteries and veins. And management of the fourth stage of labor, suture the episiotomy or any lacerations has been occurred, that is first, second degree or third, fourth. Estimate blood loss, take cord blood for hemoglobin, blood group, Rh bilirubin, and Coombs test if we found Rh negative mother. Check the BP, pulse, temperature, abnormal vaginal bleeding and firmness of the uterus before transferring to the patient. So these are the basic things we have to do after the delivery, after the third stage of labor. So this is about the normal labor and management of four stages. Hope you people have understood. If you have any kinds of doubt, please contact.